was warmer and drier. We actually had a lot more sunshine compared to Saturday. Unfortunately, we will go down in terms of temperature as we go through the day tomorrow, as we do have another chance of some rain showers. Let's take a look at our first alert sky cam in Fargo right now, as we do have partly cloudy to mostly clear skies across the region, staying dry, and temperatures not bad as we stay mild for this time of night and this time of year. Current high temperatures around the region. Now, we made it into the mid to upper 50s from the Red River and points off to the west, and some areas into portions of Lakes Country and northwestern Minnesota. High temperatures today into the lower 40s. Here's a look at the current temperatures around the region. Mid to upper 30s from Lakes Country into northwestern Minnesota, and low to mid 40s from the Red River out toward Jamestown and Devil's Lake. And the winds flipped around from a northerly direction yesterday to more of a southerly direction. A little bit of a breeze today, as we did have winds around 10 to 20 miles per hour that did warm us up pretty nicely. So in our southern and southeastern counties, we do have clear skies right now, but you can see more clouds making their way in out toward Jamestown, Devil's Lake, the Grand Forks area points off to the north, mainly cloudy skies. And in our far northern counties, from Thiefer Falls, New Fulton, Roseau, out toward Hallock, some light rain showers. Most of us staying dry, though. Do have this disturbance that's making its way through. There's our southerly wind. Behind a cold front that's going to move through during the overnight, we do have brisk northwesterly winds that will cool us down. So here's what we're looking at in terms of what to expect for tomorrow. We do have a fire weather watch in effect for our South Dakota counties and Grant and Traverse County in Minnesota. Any fires that do start could spread rapidly. Also, in the far northern valley through the morning tomorrow, we do have the possibility of some brief heavy snow that will reduce visibility and possibly coat the roads and make them slippery. Let's take a look at that hour-by-hour forecast. And the best chance of having some rain showers overnight is up north. And increase in clouds will be the story for most of us. Temperatures starting off near 40 degrees. And as we make our way through the 6 to 9 a.m. hour, the snow up to our north could be briefly heavy, so be aware of that if you're traveling in that direction. And anybody has a chance of some rain showers through the afternoon as the winds flip around to a northwesterly direction, become a little breezy out there, and that will keep us cool. A high of only 47 in the Fargo area. Some areas up north will not make it out of the upper 30s for highs. And then as we go through the day on Tuesday, we're starting off into the 20s, mainly dry, maybe a snow shower or two, but a wide range of high temperatures by the afternoon, only into the 30s into northwestern Minnesota, and we could be into the mid-60s out toward Jamestown and Ellendale. Here's the photo of the day. It's called Just Out for a Drive. Thank you to Tracy for this one, using the background of the 7-day forecast. And as we make our way through the day tomorrow, cool, windy, a high of 47, chance of some rain showers, but drier for Tuesday. Tuesday, Fargo a high of 58 degrees, then 64 on Wednesday, as we do have partly cloudy skies. Now rain shower chances will be common Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, mid to upper 50s, and back to dry weather with partly cloudy skies for next Sunday and a high of 61 degrees.
You know, rain's a lot better than snow right now, so I'll take that. And those 60s, those look awfully enticing, Justin. Thanks
yeah,
so
we
much.
Should be near 60 this time of year.
Well, I'm definitely excited for it. Thanks so much. Still ahead on Valley News Live at 10, states are competing to get protective equipment. We look at the backlog on orders.